Have any of your memories returned yet, Mayura?
Nope, none at all.
Oh, this might take longer than we thought.
This may sound weird, but I don't think I want to remember.
You said something like that before, yeah.
Right now, I'm having much too much fun making new memories.
That's a really positive way to look at it.
Yep, it's all thanks to everyone's help.
Hey, Mitsuhide.
Yeah?
We got in a fight once before, right?
Yeah, we did.
What was it about again?
Don't tell me you forgot.
The fact I can't remember means it wasn't anything important.
To hell it wasn't. You keep trying to do everything on your own. And I was telling you that you could, you know, try leaning on me for once.
Yeah, I remember that part. It's how we got there that I forget. What started it again?
The fact that you can't remember means it wasn't very important.
You haven't changed a bit since you came here, Koharu.
You've changed some, though, Kanata.
Me? Really?
Yeah, you've gotten, I don't know, more reliable, less flaky, almost cool.
You think so?
Yep. Anyway, are you sure I haven't changed?
Yeah, you're still the same old you.
Really? Are you absolutely certain? Look a little closer.
I'm certain. You haven't changed there either.
Hold it. Are you making fun of me?
Hey, Kiriya. Back on Earth, you were a leader of sorts, right?
Yeah, not by choice, though.
I just kind of fell into the role of leader here, and,
I don't have a problem with it. Do you?
Just because I have Yamatoga's voice doesn't make me any kind of...
Yeah, that ain't the only reason.
Really?
If my gang had you for a leader, they'd probably still be...
Kiriya.
It's nothing. Forget it.
Suzaku, do you have any siblings?
Yeah, a little brother named Shota.
Huh. So you're a big sister then?
He's totally unlike me. He's smart, sensible, likes people too. He's even chewed me out a couple times, like he was the older one.
You love your brother a lot, don't you?
Hey, don't say that.
Wow, it's not every day that we see you blush, Suzaku.
You've got to be an only child.
Huh? How can you tell?
It's obvious.
It's been a while since we've had any time alone together.
The last time was when we were on Earth, I believe.
It's like it's been forever and a day.
True. Everything has changed since then.
Yeah, everything is completely different.
Yet here we are, still together.
Ren, you're the heir to the Ogami family, right?
Yep.
Like, really?
Uh-huh. Why?
I remember seeing your father and your grandfather in a photo once.
And we look nothing alike, right?
No, you don't.
Yeah, those two are old school businessmen through and through. And lucky I dodged that bullet.
But they both have this, I don't know, aura of dignity about them?
Oh, I see. So you're trying to say I don't have any dignity?
To be honest, yeah.
Gah!
I loved watching hero shows when I was little, too.
Really? I knew it. Everyone goes through that phase at some point.
Every week, I'd wait breathlessly in front of the TV for it to start.
Yeah, you don't want to miss the opening song.
For a while, I seriously wanted to be a hero when I grew up.
Yeah, but...
But what?
We use special powers to fight evil now, right? Isn't that hero-ish?
You're right. Still, the most important thing to a hero is their reason for fighting.
That's true. Kanata, why do you fight?
Good question, that. Hey, Emma, are you getting along with everyone okay?
On Earth, everyone was nice to me, but they were cold.
Is that so?
Here, everyone is warm.
Yeah, they're all good people.
Yes.
But what about Kiriya?
He isn't nice, but he is warm.
Really?
Definitely.
Emma, you really get to the heart of things, don't you?
Yes.
It feels like it's been forever since we've been able to talk alone.
Yeah, we've gathered quite the crowd here.
When I first got here all by myself, I knew something had to be starting.
I thought I'd reached the end of the line.
As soon as I met you, I was like, here we go.
You're pretty amazing, Mayura.
Oh? Why?
No matter how bad things get, you're always upbeat and happy.
That's because I don't think about things too hard.
Actually, I learned to enjoy life to its fullest just by watching you.
Does that really matter now that we're all going to live forever?
Yeah. In fact, I think we'll all need to learn that before too long.
Mitsuhide, you and Koharu came here together, right?
Hmm? Yeah, I guess you could say that. Good thing you were able to meet up with Kanata as quick as you did.
Yeah, I'm very happy I found him.
He's a pretty solid guy, right? Me and Koharu, we panicked like idiots. But then you two found us, and the rest, as they say, is history.
Now we found a whole bunch more people.
Yeah, I'm glad we did too.
Yeah, I'm happy I got to meet all of you. Why don't you practice cooking with me?
Hey, what's this? You want me to teach you how to cook?
No, I asked if you wanted to come and practice with me.
True, it does seem like your cooking needs a little something.
Let me be blunt.
No, stop! I don't want to face reality! Let me stay blind to the truth and keep going for quantity over quality!
But it's our turn to cook for everyone tomorrow.
Oh crap, that's bad.
Suzaku, when I first met you, I thought you were really scary.
I'm sure you did.
But then I got to know you. And you are actually super nice.
Enough of that. I'm a pretty horrible person, to be honest.
Don't say that.
Sometimes I even wish I could just forget everything and start over.
Do you really?
Oh, shit. I'm sorry.
Hmm?
I didn't mean it that way. It's gotta be tough, having amnesia.
Oh, right. I get it now.
See? I told you I was a horrible person.
Yep. You're definitely a nice person. Ranze, can I ask you a really big favor?
Certainly. If it's anything I can do, I will gladly help.
I want you to help me study.
Study?
It seems like everybody just knows lots more stuff than I do.
Perhaps that has something to do with your amnesia.
I don't know. It feels like it's all stuff I never really learned.
I see. Of course I'll do what I can to help.
Thank you. I tried asking Koharu for help, but she said she was busy and that I should ask you instead.
I see. So a bored Koharu with nothing better to do said she was busy.
Yep. A bored Koharu with nothing better to do told me to see you. What's that you have, Ren? A mini TV? That's so cool.
Oh, what? You mean my smartphone?
A smartphone?
Ooh, Mayura, your amnesia's pretty dang bad if you don't know these.
Oh, that's okay. I don't think it has anything to do with my amnesia.
Come again?
Yep. I have a feeling that I've never seen one of those before.
Oh, that's insane.
So, what do you watch on your smartphone TV?
Well, they aren't TVs. They're phones.
Huh? Telephones?
Yep. You use them to send texts and talk with friends long distance.
Wow. Is that fun?
I don't know. I don't have any friends to talk to.
Me, I like talking to my friends when we're all together, like this. Don't you think that's fun?
Yeah, it is pretty fun.
Emma, when you came here, you regained sight in your right eye?
Yes, Yamatoka said coming here healed it.
But when I came here, I lost all my memories.
Does that make you sad?
Nope.
Oh.
If I don't have any memories, does that mean my world is cut in half?
No.
I guess it wouldn't be.
Definitely not.
Kanata.
Yeah?
I'm glad I met you.
It was Yamatoga's power that killed the Shasur, not mine.
I'm talking about back on Earth.
I'm glad I met you too.
Hey, Koharu.
What's up, Mitsuhide?
It's funny just how much stuff we end up doing together.
True. Our families are neighbors. We went to all the same schools.
Kindergarten to high school. We even came to a different world together.
So, what's next after that?
Easy. We go back to being neighbors on Earth.
Sheesh.
Suzaku, is it true you worked as a model?
It was just a part-time gig, but yeah.
Part-time or not, that's still pretty awesome.
Stop it.
Thinking about it, you are kind of pretty. And you have a unique style.
Hey, stop staring at me like that. It's embarrassing.
Come on, don't be bashful. Heck, maybe being a model is your true calling.
You think so?
Yeah. Pictures won't out your bad language and worse attitude at all.
Ouch!
What's wrong?
The fact that you were trying to be nice makes it even worse.
What was high school like for you, Namero?
Didn't go.
Guess that's a valid life choice, too.
Wasn't in Japan at that age.
Really? Then where were you?
I was working. In a DMZ somewhere, I think.
I guess that counts as a life choice, too. All that Naginata training is really paying off here, isn't it?
Yes, though that was hardly my intent when I first began training.
Yeah, but still, your skill with that thing is pretty damn impressive.
You are skilled yourself, Mitsuhide. It's heartening knowing you are here.
Yeah, but I'm still nowhere near as good as my grandpa.
Is that so?
Yep, but if I can be a use to everyone, I think he'd be proud of me.
If it helps, I'm already proud of you.
Come on, you're embarrassing me. Man, I'd kill for some ramen right now.
Yeah, that's good, but wouldn't you want some foie gras instead?
Oh, and some pot stickers.
Oh, don't forget the shark fin soup!
And maybe I'd get a half serving of fried rice on the side, too.
Oh, no, go for some caviar! Caviar!
Ren, I've never had any of that stuff. It's way too expensive.
Really, Mitsuhide? Well, who knows? When we get back to Earth, you might get to try them.
Yeah.
Man, am I really that much of a hanger-on?
Where did that come from?
I was just thinking that, you know, I'm not really that useful, am I?
No, you are.
Are you sure?
You've been kicking butt in our fights, right?
And outside of battle? What? Nothing? Really?
I'm surprised it bothers you this much.
Well, yeah. I am a girl, after all.
That's not a very convincing argument.
It's not, is it? Hey, Tagachi, your soul got hacked into 12 pieces, right?
Don't call me Tagachi.
Then they all flew to Earth where they got stuck in 12 people.
Correct.
Of those 12 people, one of them is me.
Correct.
Why me?
Sheer happenstance. Given the choice, I never would have picked you, girl.
Don't call me girl. Tagachi, what would happen if your soul gets put back together?
A long-desired wish will be granted.
Really? Can I have it?
No. It's mine.
I'll use it to become a supermodel! I'd be happy even if it didn't come with the super part.
Sorry, but no.
Tagachi, you and Zenobia were fighting against Amatsume, right?
You have been told that before, yes.
But now you're fighting the Shasur, who are Zenobia's henchmen?
Why must you keep asking the same questions over and over again?
But it's all
so confusing. And asking Kanata again feels kind of awkward.
You know, talking to Yamatoga pretty much means you're talking to me, too.
Oh.
You really are an idiot, aren't you?
No, shut up!
Togachi and Zenobia were trying to kill this world's guardian, Amatsume.
Mm-hmm.
Togachi's soul got chopped up and sent to Earth, becoming part of us.
Uh-huh.
And if Togachi's soul is put back together, that'd be bad for everyone. So Amatsume yanked the pieces back here to keep an eye on them.
Mm-hmm.
And since they were in us, we all got dragged along for the ride.
Uh-huh.
What the hell? That means we're all just collateral damage in this.
You're just figuring that out now.
You and Kanata have almost the exact same hair color.
Yep, we do.
Kanata says his is natural. Is yours some kind of fashion statement?
Hmm. Good question.
Oh, that's right. You wouldn't remember that, would you?
Nope, sorry.
You don't look the type who would dye her hair.
Hey, Koharu.
Yeah?
Is my hair fashionable at all?
Yep, it is. Souls really do exist, don't they?
Don't you think this whole planet is one big proof of that?
So if souls exist, then it follows that those exist too, right?
Those what?
Ghosts!
Ah!
Souls gather here, right? That means there's probably jillions around.
Don't be stupid. Ghosts don't exist.
Ooh, I know. Let's go ghost hunting sometime.
There's no point in hunting for something that doesn't exist.
But they do!
No, they don't.
Hmm. Wait a second. Suzaku, don't tell me you're...
I am not afraid of ghosts.
Yo, how's it hanging, Richie Rich?
I know I'm rich and all, but seriously?
Don't like it?
Can't you think of something better?
Let me try again. Ahem. Yo, how's it hanging, fanboy?
Damn. Okay, I'm one of those two, but still.
Still not feeling it?
Are you sure you can't think of anything better?
Catboy. Mr. Stripey Shirt. Shorty Pants.
Anything else? I guess I can live with Mr. Stripey Shirt.
Sure thing, Ren.
Yes! That's the one!
Hey, Yui, have you ever thought about being something other than a hero?
Nope. A hero it is for me.
Are you sure? Haven't you wanted to try being an idol?
An idol?
Yeah, I think you'd do better at that than the whole hero thing.
What? I couldn't. Never. It's too embarrassing.
And you aren't embarrassed doing hero stuff?
When you put it that way.
See? You might be able to get used to it after all. Thank you.
What have you been doing, Kanata?
What do you mean?
You look like you're getting real used to fighting.
Oh, that? Nothing really.
Mitsuhide ain't bad either.
Him? He's been practicing. I know that.
Oh, has he now?
But if we ever had to go toe-to-toe with you, you'd destroy us.
Fighting each other? I really don't want to talk about that crap. Especially with you guys. Yo! Miss Class President!
Huh? I resigned from the position of Class President earlier in the year.
Oh. Okay.
So please, just call me Ranze.
I was just trying to make a joke, you know.
If that was the case, you failed. In comedy, delivery is everything.
Really now?
Now that was funny.
Right. That'll teach me to try doing anything new.
I'm kind of shocked you're the type to drop so much on clothes, Kanata.
Huh? My clothes cost that much?
They sure as hell ain't cheap. Wait, don't you buy your own clothes?
Nah, I just wear whatever my parents buy me.
You let your parents dress you? The hell? Don't you care how you look?
Not really. What about you, Suzaku? I take it you care about your clothes.
Well, duh! I'm a model, you know? Only part-time, though.
Did you pick that outfit?
This? Nah. The designer let me keep it after I did a photo shoot for him.
Wow. That's some pretty incredible fashion sense.
I feel really, really stupid right now. You're a super nice girl, Mayura.
Huh?
If I was half as nice as you, my life would be a hell of a lot easier.
Really?
Yeah. I got jaded way too fast. Never learned to let dumb stuff slide. Sometimes I wonder why... never mind. I doubt you want to hear me whine.
But I think you're an awfully nice and sweet person too, Suzaku. Huh? Why is your face turning red?
Because you can be too damned nice sometimes. Mitsuhide, do you have a girlfriend?
Nope. What about you, Suzaku? Have a boyfriend?
Never really wanted one.
Wait, you're at least popular with the guys though, right?
What do you mean, at least?
Seriously, you're pretty hot. I bet a ton of guys want to get with you.
You think?
Yeah, and the total letdown doesn't come until after they talk to you. You sound like a drill sergeant. And the hate-fueled cynicism is cute, so I'm sure there are guys who will tolerate it. But seriously, as soon as you open your mouth, it's like, whoa, what a bitch. Just keep your mouth shut and you'll be way more popular.
Same goes for you. Well, ain't this unusual? You by yourself?
Hey, Suzaku!
What's wrong? You're not bouncing off the walls like usual.
Just between you and me, I realized I really miss going to school.
I didn't take you for the studious type.
No, I'm not. Like, I'm really not.
Still, I'm kind of jealous.
Oh, really?
Yeah. See, I never really had the, patience for school, I guess.
Well, yeah, you're the bad girl type.
Hey!
What?
You know, if you'd been around, school might have been a lot more fun. You know, Ranze, you have this real proper lady thing going on.
Oh, do I?
Yeah. To be honest, it makes it kind of hard to approach you.
But you do come speak with me.
Yeah, I do, come to think of it. Hmm? What's so funny?
This reminds me of the first time I met Koharu.
Really? You're kidding me.
For what I do.
Yeah, but as an adult.
Stop.
Flexible.
Yeah, not her. Mitsuhide.
Yeah?
You've got real talent.
I seriously have no idea what you're talking about.
Don't you think you want to make good use of it?
No. I'd rather live out the normal, boring life I've been given.
You won't be able to go back once you hear what I have to say next.
And that's exactly why I don't want to hear it!
You sure?
Very!
Huh? How old am I?
Yep, I'm curious.
Little over 20.
Whoa! You're way younger than I thought. You sure don't look anywhere near 20. You must have had it rough.
Perhaps.
Well, what about me? What do you think?
You look your age.
Aw, but I don't got it easy either.
Yo, Prince.
Would you not call me that, please?
Life here's gotta be rough on a kid used to the rich life like you.
Well, yeah. It's scary and harsh and freaky and hard, but...
But?
I learned that it's pretty cool to do stuff to help out my friends.
Really?
But you're right in that I'm just a wussy rich kid who can't do much.
The breakfast you made for everyone today was really good, Ren.
You're welcome.
It's a hero's job to take down bad guys, right?
Right! No evildoer is safe! Not even you would be spared, Namero!
Really? Beating me would be... difficult.
What? Oh, no! I wouldn't!
If the time comes, remember. No quarter asked or taken.
Wrong!
What?
Bad guys are supposed to go easy on the heroes.
Really?
But even if you did go easy on me, I would still lose to you.
Heroes aren't supposed to lose to the bad guys.
I know! So please don't let anything like that happen. Ever!
You've changed a great deal since coming here, Kanata.
Mitsuhide and Koharu said pretty much the same thing.
Is that so?
Yeah.
Seeing how strange this place is, things changing is almost a given.
But there is one thing about me that I'm sure will never change.
Oh? And what is that?
That's a secret.
I wonder... is there even such a thing as something that never changes? Mayura, Kanata was the first one you met here, correct?
Yep. Now that I think about it, I got super lucky. After that, Yamatoga brought all of us together.
Yes.
But you managed to make it on your own until then. That's amazing.
Amazing? I thought it somewhat strange. Somehow, I not only knew everyone was here, but where to go find them.
It must have been the power of love. I'm sure of it.
It seems I was lucky, too. I'm glad you're here, Mitsuhide. I always know I can count on you.
Ranze?
Yes?
You're the only person to ever say that to me.
Oh?
Kanata refuses to trust me, and Koharu is clueless about my good points.
Is that so?
I swear, you're the only person who understands me.
Really?
So, stop being so damned enigmatic all the time.
Am I? Kiriya!
Huh? What?
It was your turn to clean yesterday, correct?
Yeah, and I did.
That does not count as clean.
Ugh, stop your bitching.
You will not take that tone with me. It is high time for you to act in a more mature and responsible manner.
Yeah, yeah.
And we must do something to curtail that rebellious attitude of yours. Just look at you. Your clothing is wrinkled and your hair is a mess. Pull your pants up. Your shirt is filthy. You look like a ragamuffin. Did you wash your face? You have bags under your eyes. Brush your teeth.
I'm sorry, ma'am.
Being a champion of justice must be exhausting, Yui.
It can be, but after seeing you in action, my confidence is kind of toast.
Why is that?
You look way more heroic than I do whenever we're fighting monsters.
Me? Heroic?
Yeah. You're beautiful, strong, and compassionate. You can do anything.
If that's how I appear, it's because I make an effort to be that way.
Now that I think about it, you'd be a better fit for this costume than I am.
Not at all.
Never mind. I doubt you'd want to wear something like this.
It takes far more than putting on a costume to become a hero, right?
Right.
I've never once thought to become a hero to give children happy dreams. However, should I choose to become a hero, I will gladly wear that costume.
Oh, so you'd be okay with wearing it now?
Should the time come when I follow in your footsteps, I would. Emma, you're always so calm.
Yes.
Koharu could learn a thing or two from you.
Perhaps.
She's way too hyperactive. She really needs to learn to sit still.
Maybe.
Goodness. Have you no expressions, Emma? You could look even lovelier.
Debatable.
Come on now, give me a smile.
Takes too much effort.
You know, maybe you could stand to learn a thing or two from Koharu.
Really?
Yes, really.
Hey, Kanata. I hear you grew up in a pretty posh family.
It's flattering to hear you call it posh. It's really just traditional.
But if you're getting betrothed and stuff, it's gotta be pretty up there.
Nah. Our parents are just really good friends with each other.
Yeah, but still, you get Ranze out of the deal. I'd call that a win.
Come on, you're making me blush. Anyway, don't you have anything like that, Ren?
Nope, nothing like that for me. My family's pretty flexible that way.
I figured as much.
You could tell?
Well, going by your outfit and your hobbies, yeah.
You know both my pop and my grandpa are like this in private, right?
What? You've got to be kidding.
Yep, I'm definitely kidding. Aha! Hey, Mayura.
Aha! Hey, Ren.
What the...
How you doing today? Lols, IMHO, OMG!
What the...
Well, what do you think? I've been practicing those words you taught me.
Why?
Because they sounded interesting? Which dialect are they from?
Not really a dialect.
Oh, so they're not a part of a dialect, ROFL? What?
Lols. Looks like you've got a long way to go yet. Hey, Mitsuhide.
What's up?
When we get back to Earth...
Uh-oh, heavy story incoming?
Maybe...
What? It isn't like you to get all serious.
Can I, come visit you sometime?
What? Is that it? Don't be stupid. Come over whenever you want.
Really? Oh, cool.
Hell, Koharu comes and hangs out even if I'm not there.
Yeah, but it's just, well, you know what kind of family I have. It's kind of hard to put into words.
Whatever. Now you have to come by.
Hey, Koharu. Do you play games and stuff?
You bet. I love them. But if I play them too much, Mitsuhide gets mad.
Ooh, that sucks. Oh, what about TV? Have any favorite shows?
Loads! But if I sit around watching them too much, Kanata gets mad.
Yikes!
And if I spend too much time fiddling with my smartphone, Ranze gets mad.
Yowzers. Looks like you're getting a real strict upbringing.
You don't know the half of it. They're always nagging me. Oh, but nobody knows about the late-night radio shows, though.
Whoa! Talk about old school!
Ooh, keep it a secret, okay?
Roger.
I've even sent in postcards to them. They've read a few on air!
Yeah. I'll keep that a secret. For more than one reason. You know, Namero, you've got some mad skills and knowledge.
You think?
Well, you can do all sorts of cool stuff, which is a big help to everyone.
I just look out for myself, but it helps others is coincidence.
So that's how you see things, huh? You know, no matter which way you think about it, the results are real cool.
Thanks.
To cook tomorrow. Have any requests?
I'm okay with whatever. Everything you make is really good, Yui.
Thanks. I'm happy to hear you like my cooking.
It's not just cooking either. You're good at housekeeping in general.
Yeah, I did a lot of helping with that stuff in the orphanage.
You're going to make someone an awesome wife someday.
Don't let Ranze hear you say that. She'll get mad at you.
I doubt that.
I hear you're really popular with little kids too, Koharu.
I don't know about popular, but I do play baseball and stuff with them.
Really? That's neat.
Yeah, they're always dragging me outside to play with them.
Wow, they must really like you.
Well, yeah. Star pitcher and team slugger and all that. You're really popular with the kids too, right? You being a hero and all.
Me? Well,
yeah?
It's kind of more like the kids are letting me play with them.
Yikes! I can kind of see that, though.
I wish you didn't. Ranze?
Yes?
Could I ask you to teach me some recipes?
I guess, but why?
Everything you make is so good, it could be from a fancy restaurant.
Is that so? But what you cook is always very tasty, Yui.
Yeah, but it's not, I don't know, impressive. It's all pretty ordinary.
Is that a bad thing?
Not really. Just kinda boring.
Is that so?
So you teach me how to cook like you do?
No.
Aw, why not?
Because I like the way your cooking is now.
Emma, what's wrong?
Yui, you farted.
What are you talking about? I did not! No, stop! Stop! It wasn't gas, it was a special attack! Yeah!
Heroes use poison gas attacks?
Stop! Please!
I had a dream.
A dream?
Yes, about you.
Oh, what was it like?
You were alone.
Alone?
Yes.
Really?
Really. Mayura.
Yes, Emma?
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow what?
Tomorrow is cleaning day.
Yep. Let's both give it our best, okay?
All is in readiness.
Boy, you really like cleaning, don't you, Emma?
Yes.
Let's both make sure everything is sparkling clean tomorrow.
While my hands are stained black with dirt and filth.
You like that part of it?
Yes. You hate me.
Emma, what I have against Kagato has nothing to do with you.
Kagato and I are two halves of the same whole.
To me, Kagato is Kagato and you're you.
Yet you still hate me.
No, I don't hate you. I just can't get a grip on who you are.
Then here, get a grip on me.
There, see? That's exactly what I mean.
Huh? What do you like, Ranze?
That is a rather vague question.
Answer me, now.
Now? But what sort of answer are you looking for? Foods, colors, hobbies? If you don't narrow down the field of possibilities, I can't answer you.
What do you like, Ranze?
Pandas!
You like pandas?
Yes,
I like pandas more than anything else. I think.
Of course.
How would you know that?
Do your hero thing.
Sure thing, Emma! I have come from a faraway planet. I am Ranger Ultra Pink! There! Do you feel any braver now, Emma?
Yes.
Really? That's great!
I feel more confident.
Oh, how so?
Because as bad as I am, I'm not you.